Today, we will look at one of the most important tools we use to overcome the flesh, the world, and the devil. We're going to be looking at the tool. So scripture, in all of its entirety, is a powerful tool for us to live this overcoming life. Amen? The Word of God is active, living, and alive, and it influences every area of our lives. So, which means when we look, if we want to overcome, we abide in God's Word. Whatever your situations may be today, we are helping ourselves to understand that I have to abide, I have to come back to the Word of God in order to overcome. So the key is to have the Word of God alive and active in us. It has to be bubbling in us. It can't be dormant. It can't be asleep. It can't be scratched to wake up. It has to be active. Now, how do we do this? Today, we'll share three simple practices to overcome with the Word as we go in through our journey. So the first one is to feed your inner person with the Word. So as believers, we all need to understand that nothing can take the place of us reading and meditating on God's Word on your own. You cannot, like, for example, those of you who had breakfast this morning, all because you fed your family does not keep your stomach full. Although mothers say that for some reason. Right? But until and unless you consume, you're not going to have strength or energy. You need to be in a place to read or to feed yourself the Word. Acts 20:32. So now, brethren, I commend you to God and to the Word of His grace, which is able to build you up and give you an inheritance among all those who are sanctified. So when you feed yourself, you not only are strengthened and nourished, but you also walk in what has given as His inheritance to all those who believe in Him. So when you feed, you grow, as well as you have everything that the Lord has given to you. So that's important for us to be strong. And in order to be strong, we need to feed ourselves. The next is to renew our minds with the Word. Renew our minds with the Word. You know, when you constantly feed yourself, you will begin to change, right? If you eat too much of food, you will grow sideways, right? But this is a good thing in the spiritual world. When you feed yourself, it will begin to change you. It will begin to change your thoughts, your ideas, your lifestyle. It will begin to renew you. So the more you feed, the more the renovation takes place, the regeneration takes place. So the word renew is equivalent to thinking in ways that align to God's ways and thoughts. So when you feed healthy, you will begin to renew healthy. So when you feed God's Word, you will begin to align yourself in God's ways and God's thoughts. We go to the last practice that we need to do is to speak the Word of God. Now, God instructs us to speak the Word. You know what God has likened the Word of God to? In Ephesians 6:17, it says, take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God. What does the sword indicate? It indicates a weapon. So today, when we are to be speaking the Word, you need to ask yourself, have I not read this somewhere? Because Jesus used the Word of God as a weapon. So just like that, we, in every situation, whatever our situations may be today, you know, it sometimes seems so simple, but the fact is it has immense power. It has immense power over the enemy. It has immense power over our fleshly desires or our lusts, and it has immense power over the things of the world. So when we have this, let's speak it. So take the authority that God has given you. Fill your heart with these truths that you've heard today. We overcome because of the word.